Yo, what is going on, guys, and welcome back to today's video. And in today's video, I'm going to be counting down the 5 most disappointing teams so far in the 2017-18 NHL season. Kicking the list off at number 5 is the New York Islanders, and by no means are they having a garbage season. Their record is 25-20-5, which is over 500. They're 1 point out of a wildcard spot and 7th in the Metro Division, which is a very tight division. From the last place team and the first place team in it, you can make a case for either any of these teams in this division to come out on top of that division by the end of the year. It's a very close race, but last year they were 49-21-12. They missed out on the playoffs, but they have so much individual talent on this team. Like this year, Josh Bailey, 46 games played, 54 points. You know, they have one of the best centers in the NHL in John Tavares, and they have a rookie sensation in Matthew Barzal, 50 games played for him, 51 points, so he's over a point a game. Jordan Eberle isn't really producing like I think they wanted him to. 39 points in 50 games is by no means terrible. But and also Anders Lee, 27 goals. That's up there with the lead in the NHL around the top. So yeah, New York Islanders, I think they should be doing better for the individual success they have on their team. But hopefully they can close out the season very strong and make a push in the playoffs. Next up at number 4 is the Montreal Canadiens. Last year they had an unbelievable regular season, finishing 47-26-9, first in the Atlantic, obviously getting bumped from the playoffs, and they really just can't find that team that they need to make it to the finals. You know, 20-23-6 this year. They have no business being 10 points out of the playoffs and 5th in the Atlantic Division with the roster they have. Carey Price, one of the best goalies, if not, you can make a case for him being the best goalie in the world. And you just think that the roster they have can get it done, but obviously they haven't been able to. Max Pacioretty has been the center of attention in trade talks. Jonathan Drouin is not producing like they want him to when they acquired him, only 26 points in 44 games. They kind of thought he could be the superstar for their team, but obviously not, as they're having a pretty disappointing season. Hopefully they can turn it around because they're not completely out yet, but yeah, I don't think the Montreal Canadiens fans should be very happy right now with the way their team's playing. Next up at number 3 is the Chicago Blackhawks, and these guys should be up there in the top 2 teams in the NHL, I think, as they really have had a dynasty for the last 10 years, and the team they have no business with a 23-19-7 record, 4 points out of the playoffs, and 7th in the Central Division, as last year they finished 50-23-9, first in the Central Division. I think Chicago should be having a much, much better season than they are. I still think they're going to make the playoffs. I think they're going to turn it around in the second half, but as of right now, it's pretty disappointing. They acquired Anthony Duclair to hopefully get some more offense, but DeBrincat has been giving them some pretty good offense unexpectedly. Patrick Kane, obviously, 49 points, 49 games. He's always just a great player, but point machine. Jonathan Toews, only 32 points in 49 games played. Hopefully they can get more out of him in the second half of the season, because I really think this team has no business being where they are right now, and it's a pretty disappointing first half of the season for the Blackhawks. Coming in at number 2, and this one kind of pains me, it's the Ottawa Senators. I really do like to see Canadian teams do good. They're not my favorite team by any means, but I was really pulling for them last year in the playoffs. They were one goal away from making it to the Stanley Cup final, and now they have a record of 15-23-9 and are 7th in the Atlantic Division. Last year's regular season, they finished 48-24-10, and that was good enough for 2nd in the Atlantic Division, and they made it to double overtime Game 7 of the Eastern Conference Finals against the Pittsburgh Penguins, and they were not able to pull it out. It really sucks that they're having such a bad season. They picked up Matt Duchene, hopefully, to put some offense into this team, but, you know, I just don't understand the roster they have. They got Craig Anderson, Stone, Hoffman, Carlson, Duchene, all these guys, and they just really can't get anything going this year. Hopefully they can turn it around. I really don't think they have any chance of making the playoffs, but hopefully they can turn it around and, you know, have some positive vibes going into the offseason. And finally, coming in at number 1, this should be no surprise to most of you, the Edmonton Oilers, the team I actually picked in my prediction videos at the beginning of the year to win the Stanley Cup this year. And they're not even in a playoff spot, and they're really not that close to a playoff spot. They're 10 points out with a 22-24-3 record, 6th in the Pacific Division. They have arguably the best player in the NHL, and Leon Draisaitl, and a great supporting cast, and they just really can't get anything going this year. Connor McDavid was off to a slow start. He's been playing a lot better as of late. Cam Talbot actually just came out and said he thinks that they're going to make the playoffs still, and that is a possibility, as they have the firepower to just turn it around and go on a huge win streak. And I really hope they do, because I want to see Edmonton succeed. Obviously, their fan base hasn't had a lot to cheer for lately. Besides last year, they made a pretty good playoff push. 47-26-9, second in the Pacific last year. And they have really just went downhill since then. So yeah, let me know what you guys think about the Edmonton Oilers, and if you think they're going to turn it around and make the playoffs, down in the comment section below. So that's going to wrap up this video, guys. I really hope you did enjoy. If you did, make sure to like this video and subscribe to the channel if you have not already. And if your team is on this video, just don't go hating. I'm not saying that they're a bad team. I'm saying I had high expectations coming into the season because they're supposed to be a good team, but obviously underachieving a lot this year. So yeah, let me know if your guys' favorite team is on here, if you think that they can turn it around, make a push for the playoffs. Hopefully all these teams can turn it around and get some momentum going into the offseason and going into next season. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you guys in the next one.